Hey, what's going on, guys? So in this video, me and Anthony are going to be showing you guys behind the scenes of what exactly we would be doing if we were finding the right influencers for a campaign. So we've got Anthony sharing his screen right here, and we're going to get right into it.
Right. So one thing that when most people are looking up how to go ahead and find an influencer, whether this is for a shout out, and this is one thing I want to make clear, guys. Whether you're trying to find an influencer to promote your giveaway, whether you're trying to find an influencer to promote your shout out, this is the process you want to go down for selecting an influencer, determining whether or not they're going to be a good fit for you, all that stuff. So to find an influencer for anything, this is the exact thing you're going to follow. A lot of people just look at engagement and that's it. Me and Leo go through a much more refined process. This is the exact same process we use to find other influencers. And today, literally, what we want to do is we want to just go ahead and pick a niche, and we want you guys to literally just watch us do our own research. So me and Leo are going to literally pretend like we're trying to grow an account. Leo, what niche do you want to use? What should we do today? We want to do
Yeah,
travel,
so
fitness.
in regards to, yeah, let's go for the fitness niche. I think that's an easy one that we can go down.
Okay, so me and Leo are going to pretend right now that we are trying to grow a fitness page, and right now we're going to go ahead and basically take you guys right behind the scenes, show you, exactly how we look up fitness pages, and then how we do all the
Our
market
thought
research.
process.
Right. And then we're going to do all the research, and then what we're going to tell you whether or not we would go with this influencer at the end. So, all right, Leo, let's do some fitness. Do you know any fitness pages to start off on, or should I just start searching up fitness?
No. Yeah, so right off the bat, let's go ahead and search fitness in the bar,
All right,
and then we'll go and scroll through and see what we can find.
let's do it. So fitness.
So just to point out, if you guys are looking for a particular influencer in any niche, make sure that you type in the niche in the search bar, and then you can scroll through and you'll be able to definitely find some high quality pages, or potential high quality pages right off the bat.
That's definitely the easiest way to start. Whatever, and it like same thing. If you guys are looking for travel, type in travel, start there. And just to show you guys, after how would you find more related accounts? If you go right here, there's this follow button. Well, right next to that is a drop down arrow, and it's going to give you tons of related accounts, all around the same size as well. We'll be getting into that a bit later, but right now, what do you think about checking this account, Leo? Let's see. Well, first,
Yeah, so first.
before we do anything, before we even bring it into Social Blade or Social Info, the first thing we want to do is just make a no-brainer decision. Like, we know it's at 1 million followers, so let's just see what engagement's at. And then we'll know based off engagement whether or not it's even worth taking a look into. Because if the engagement's really bad, we're not even going to waste our time. And I'm
Exactly.
check this out, Leo. Like, I'm seeing this page has 1 million followers. All these posts here don't even, this one has 1K likes, but I mean, this has 800 likes.
This is a
800.
complete, yeah, this is a terrible page to go for.
Yeah.
And the main reason for that, yes, a lot of people when they're looking for influencers, the first thing they do is they look at the following. And I have worked with a bunch of people who've just saw 1 million followers and instantly they think, okay, this is a page I need to buy shout outs from. But it's quite the opposite, because if you take a look at this engagement here, the engagement is a true identifier of whether or not this page is actually high quality, whether it can actually generate traffic. Okay, so as we can see here, we're getting about, or this page is getting about 800 likes per picture, and that is definitely something you want to steer clear away if you don't want to waste your money.
Definitely. Like, yeah, especially for a 1 million page, I'd be looking for 10,000 likes minimum per picture. For a million follower page, that should be standard. Ideally, what you guys want to look for is like 2% engagement. If a page is under 2%, you probably want to stay away. So right off the bat, Leo, I'm gonna say this page is a waste of time and I want to move on to the next. What do you think?
Yep, same.
Okay, and just so you guys know, we are moving on to the next because based off of engagement, we already know this isn't a post we want to do. Because the engagement, like 300 likes on this and 600 on this, we already know it's a waste of time. So now we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna find the next account. So if we look, I'm just gonna scroll through here. Let's see, let's see what this page is like. Nah, a little too small. Not really feeling the. I'd rather go a little bigger. Fitness Wiki. 782K. All right, so guys,
That looks
first thing we're gonna
interesting.
do is check the engagement and see if it's even worth our time. So it's 700,000 followers. 35. This has
Oh,
to
definitely not.
29 minutes ago. I mean, that should have a lot more likes for 60. Yeah, okay, this page is dead too. Okay. Yeah, see guys, so this engagement is so low, we're not even gonna do the research. Man, are we gonna find a good account today, Leo?
I hope so. I hope so.
Let's see. 919.
It's all a process. Just so you guys like actually see the behind the scenes, you're not gonna find the perfect influencer like right off the bat, you know. So it's all a process. You're gonna have to do some trial and error. You know, you're gonna have to bump into some terrible pages along the way, but that's perfectly fine.
Right. So this year's getting like, you know, some do bad, like 1.4k likes, but some are doing pretty well. 12k likes here, 7k likes, 5k,
right.
900 there. So that did terrible.
So,
but as you can see as well, one thing that I noticed, this has 900 likes, Leo, but it's also really bad thumbnail. And then the content that is good content seems to be performing a lot better. So if we're posting good content on this page, it should perform pretty well.
Yeah, if you post good content, then for sure. However, I feel like it's too risky because of the fact that sometimes the engagement will be bad, sometimes it'll be good.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if you threw money at this and for some reason it didn't go viral, then you've just wasted your investment. That's why you want to be looking for something that has a consistent engagement.
Yeah.
Or high quality, high engagement.
Yeah, I wouldn't really feel this page. I would be... Let's go on to the next. So here we have gym motivation, 1.2 million. Wow, all these pages are really bad.
The fitness niche is like quite common for that, actually.
Yeah, this is...
Let me see if I can think of any.
This is really... It's almost like we're getting all these related pages. Let's niche down a bit and go bodybuilding. And let's see if there's better pages in this. Let's do... Bodybuilding motivation. Let's check this page out. 1,000, and this is a 100k page. This is like it's average. It's the bare minimum. A little less than average. I'm not really feeling this. A little too low. See, the comments is a big thing. Only like very few comments as well. This isn't very good. And this is the process you guys are basically going to go through. You know, this is, you're going to find a lot of crap pages like this. And this is literally what we did. We had to, but once you find one good page, there's normally many more good pages connected to it.
Definitely.
So let's, you know, let's go with a fitness influencer like Simeon Panda. I'm sure he has good ratios and everything.
Yeah. I'm just trying to think of some from the top of my head because...
Yeah, so I mean, this obviously Simeon Panda is a personal fitness influencer, but I mean, the contact and everything is still the same between influencer to theme page. If you're going for a shout out, we're still looking for basically the same exact things. And he's at 4.4k, so we got 49k likes. This probably was just posted, and it's an ad, so an hour ago, so we're not really going to take that into consideration. 44 likes, 70k, 93k, 124. 19. What are your thoughts, Leo, on this? The comments are matching.
Well, right off the bat. Well, the thing is, right, when you see engagement like that, you know for a fact that there is traffic that's going to be coming from that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, these are actual people who are liking on this guy's picture. And of course, you have to make sure that there are actual comments going on as well, because that proves that it's real engagement.
Mm-hmm.
But typically, if it's in those numbers, it's going to be real engagement.
Right. Okay. So yeah, I mean, if I wanted to sell, like, if let's say I wanted to, you know, market, I had a whey protein, I was trying to market this whey protein, you know, I would probably hit up this guy and market on his page. Would you, Leo?
Right. Definitely. And another thing that I want to point out real quick, if you scroll down and check out a video right now,
here's a video.
This is a trick that I always check whether or not the engagement is actually real. If you go over to a video and then you can see the amount of views that it's getting,
mm-hmm.
if it correlates with the amount of engagement, then you can tell for sure that it's real, real engagement.
Right. So here we have 866,000 views, and that has...
There we go.
How many likes does that have? I don't know if it's going to tell us the likes here. I don't think it's telling us the likes, but it does have 2.7K comments. Or here's this video right here.
I mean, just the fact that it's got...
This video here is...
Yeah, just the fact that it's got 866k views is enough to tell you that it's all real.
Like, this looks very real. 322,000 views, and then it has, I think it had 30k likes. So once we click off, it doesn't show us. But right here again, so 24k likes on this video, and then it has 196,000 views. That seems very natural to me. And it has 230 comments. So, yeah, I mean, this page looks good to me. Leo looks good to you. So now what we would do is like, okay, based off engagement, me and Leo agree, hey, this is a page that we want to either get shout outs from, we want to have this guy promote a giveaway, we want to have this guy promote a product, whatever it is, we want to use this guy as an influencer. The next step, based off of, we already established that, you know, off the engagement, he's worth looking into. That's the reason why you're looking at engagement first, so you're not wasting your time. Could you imagine all those first five bad pages if we looked into all of them and wasted our time? So the engagement is so that you don't waste your time, because your time is the most valuable asset you have. And now the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna come over to Social Blade. I'm just gonna look at some basic stuff. So I'll just type in Simeon. Let's see how we spell this guy's name. I think this is how it's spelled. And we're gonna plug him into Social Blade real quick. Leo, I don't know what you look for first, but the first thing I look for is whether or not he's gaining followers daily. That's like my thing that I always look for, just to, you know, quickly, because if someone's losing followers at a rapid rate every day, that's a big red flag for me. And right now,
that's a big red flag.
Right, and this is looking good for me so far because he's gaining every day. He's gaining 11K per month, which I think is pretty low for an account his size to be gaining 11K per month, but nonetheless, he is gaining. So that's a good sign. That's a good sign that he is gaining, and it's a pretty good influencer. Let's see. Wait, are we on? We are on YouTube. Let's switch this over to Instagram. That is why the numbers were pretty low. Yeah. So make sure, guys, if you guys are new to Social Blade, make sure you don't mistake like I just did. There's tons of these to pick from. Make sure you are under Instagram.
Right.
You don't mess up.
By the way, Anthony, before you go ahead and go onto Instagram, I just found a really good fitness page that I want everyone to see after we're done with this.
Okay, let's finish up this one and then let's go into that one.
Perfect.
Okay, cool. So here we are on his page, 4.4 million followers. This actually tells us his engagement rate. So 1.69 engagement. We're looking for, on average, the average engagement rate is 2%. But when you get into pages that are 1 million and up, it is normal for the engagement rate to start to drop off, because since they have such a huge following, they're just naturally going to have more ghost followers than usual. It's fine. 1.69% engagement for an account at 4.4 million, I think, is still very good engagement. And here we are, he is gaining, and he's gaining 119 per month. So this matches the IG numbers. Yeah, that was definitely a YouTube page for 10K per month. This already looks like good flags to me. The graphs looks very nice, very raw, natural, organic. Just a nice steady slope up. That's what you're looking for. If this graph had like a huge like just spike, I would, you know, that those are kind of like red flags of like, okay, like what happened there? You know, it's just something a little questionable. Yeah. Now it doesn't mean it's fake followers. If there are spikes, it does not mean it's fake followers. It could have been a giveaway. It could have been a massive shout out campaign, but it's just something to be wary of. Just, you know, take it into account, because ultimately what you're looking for is a lot of things that add up into making you say like, okay, this is not someone I want to work with. You know, if there's huge spikes and low engagement and they're losing followers, you can kind of tell, hey, you know what? Not going to go with this guy. So yeah, so based off this information, Leo, I would say this is pretty good. I would say this is...
I completely agree.
Right.
This would, like, an account that's gaining like this, an account that's getting this kind of engagement, this is a definite 100%. And it's a very steady, smooth follower growth. This is a plus for me, yeah.
Definitely. And now when we go ahead and we plug it into Social Info, we can actually look at the growth over the last 7 days, so we can see... We can see his posts. He's making 3 posts, 2 posts. So he's super active. He's not following, unfollowing anybody, which is great. Gaining a few thousand per day. Gained 4,000 followers today. Now we can actually see his top posts too. So we could see here's his post with 116,000 likes. We could actually go straight to that post and view it. Yep. Okay, that's that video we actually clicked on. Or was that?
Perfect.
Yeah, that was that video. So that is, everything is matching up really good. Average likes 67,000, average comments 542, engagement rate 1.5. Cool. So everything's matching up. I like to cross check between Social Blade and Social Info just to get the most accurate numbers and make sure nothing's wrong and everything's good. So what's your conclusions, Leo? What would you say?
100%. This is a page that I would definitely buy shout outs from.
Right. So just to recap what we did. What we did is we landed on Simian Panda's page. And the first thing we did is we went to check, is this worth our time? We don't want to waste our time. The way we do that is we check the engagement ratios. And you're checking, is the engagement good? But also, are there comments to match? And does it make sense? Meaning, if there's 20,000 video views and there's 20,000 likes, that doesn't make sense. Because not everybody who watches the video is going to like it. You know, always looking for those average engagement ratios. Now we know we aren't wasting our time. Plug it into Social Info or Social Blade, whichever one you want. I personally prefer Social Info. And then going ahead and making sure it's scanning every day, looking at the growth slopes. If everything is matching up, if there's not too many red flags, you're basically pretty safe. All right. So Simian Panda is a go. So Leo, you said you found another page that was pretty good?
Yep, that's right. So check out Superhuman's Power.
Superhuman's Power. Cool. So 3 million followers. Let's check this out. 4K likes, 16K likes, 40K likes. This was probably posted recently. The first post, guys, you don't want to use that. Like, don't just check that and go. See, because that's 4K likes, but posted 32 minutes ago. So that's actually really good. But if you thought that was posted a day ago, you know, then that's really bad. So make sure the first post, don't really count that, or make sure you look at when it was posted so you don't get like a false prediction. 94K, 30. Yeah, this page looks very, very well. So now, I mean, we would go ahead and plug this in. This is called Superhuman's Power. Yeah, I would definitely go and plug this in and be willing to check it out now. So if we just check it out, make sure it's all good. There we go. This is the account for sure. So let's bring up the last 30 days just to get super accurate. Okay. So gaining some days, losing others. Again, guys, this doesn't mean that it's fake followers or anything. And like right here we see, okay, today gained 2,000, you know, and then 3 days later it only gained 52. This doesn't mean it's fake. It doesn't mean anything. This could be a shout out campaign they did. It could be a giveaway and now they're losing some from the giveaway. It could be a number of factors, but that definitely is something to take into account. So today they've lost 85, but over the last 30 days they've gained 19,000. So they are gaining, however, they are losing some days. So, I mean, I usually equate that up to like, you know, maybe it's a giveaway, maybe it's a shout out campaign. Would you agree, Leo?
Yeah, 100%. I completely agree. You just need to make sure that you're not judging a page and saying, oh, this account just gained tons of followers on this particular day, and then just say, instantly assuming it's fake followers. You need to make sure that you are actually doing the right research and just not accusing it of being a fake page.
Right. Even if something gained like 20,000 followers in a day, a lot of people are like, oh, that's impossible. Guys, that's it on Instagram, that's not impossible. You can easily do that with you know, the right systems in place. So if you see massive growth, don't just knock it off as fake followers. Make sure you take a look into everything. But yeah, this looks really good. We can see some of the top posts. The most recent posts are here, 93K likes. 1% engagement rate. Again, for a page this big, 1% is really good. If I would say between pages that are between, you know, 0 to 100,000 followers to 200,000 followers, you're really looking for a 2%. After once you get into like the 1 million, you know, you kind of expect the drop off. But yeah, this page looks really good. I would definitely go ahead and buy some shout outs off this page. So I think, Leo, we've given a pretty good example of the good pages. We've gone through two good pages. Do you want to go ahead and plug in a bad page into Social Info? Try to find a bad page and just do those red flags.
See if we can find a bad page.
Right. Well, we know fitness was pretty bad. So if I pull up that page again. So this was the fitness page that we looked at first, and this was a really terrible page. But let's just verify it's terrible, right? Let's have the benefit of the doubt. Hey, maybe this is good. Let's just plug it in, and let's see what happens here really quick. All right, so we're on the correct account. Let's go over the last 30 days. So the last 30 days, it does look like it's gaining.
Yeah.
Gains, not gaining much though. 7K over 30 days for a page at a million is pretty low. Because remember, Simian was, what, 3 million and he was gaining 100K per month, over 100K. So for this to be gaining 7K, you know, I wouldn't say this page is dying, but I would say it's starting to really slow down. There is no momentum really left on it. Definitely. This is pretty flat line.
Yeah, you don't want to waste times with pages that aren't getting any momentum.
Right. You want to be on the pages that are flying, the pages that are, they're going viral. Everything's looking really good. Yeah, the graph looks good on this page. I think this page was probably a really good page at one point, and then it just slowed down. Maybe owners stopped posting, and it just looks like it's lost its momentum. It looks like it went inactive, and now basically what we have is a lot of inactivity, a lot of ghost followers, and that's why the engagement's low. This page was probably really good at one point, and now it's not in its prime. So, exactly. You know, it doesn't mean it has fake followers, doesn't mean they're doing anything unethical. It just simply means that it's not the page it probably once was.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, so, yeah, that's
and that's not a problem page. Either, you know, because, yeah, that's not a problem because there is an abundance of influencers out there, you know, so you can literally keep searching until you find that perfect fit for you. So it's never, ever a problem.
Right, never at all. So yeah, I'm trying to find an account that would maybe have really bad stats to show. Let's see. Let's just check this one out. Let's see what the stats look like.
I just found one that would be losing followers.
A bad example? Yeah, see if you find any accounts that are losing followers that we could show.
Check body dedication.
Body dedication. So 400k, 1k likes, 2k, 1.9, 2.4, 3.8.
So this was doing really good at some point. And then it seems the owner stopped posting or...
Let's check it out. Yep, this is losing. This is definitely losing. So last 3 days, lost 4,000. Yeah, so this is an account that, you know, maybe, yeah, 0.5% engagement, 400K. That's no more. If this was in the millions of followers, this wouldn't bother me too much. But the fact that it's under 1.5% engagement, not really too fond of that. Yeah, I would, based off engagement, based off losing followers every day, and based off this engagement ratio, I would come to the conclusion that this is not a page I would want to advertise on.
I would definitely agree with that.
Right. Oh, and one page that I can say for sure, it actually just came to mind. If a page looks like this, let me go to account analytics. This account was grown completely fake. Oh, now it's a private account? No way. Let's see if we have the old history on Social Blade. If an account looks like this, guys, you see this graph, we can tell right here. The account's private, so we're getting limited data. This is the old data. This is like a known fake account. So losing every day almost. And then if you see things like this, like we see this, it looks like the account was growing naturally here. Nice, nice. Then maybe like a little bit of inactivity. This looks like, you know, something, just an upward slope, then a drop off right here. Like this straight down drop off. That scares me, you know, that's not exactly, you know, something you really see normally. That could be an indicator. Doesn't mean it's fake followers. I mean, I know this account has fake followers on it. If you see this on a different account, it doesn't necessarily mean like, yeah, it's 100% fake followers, but it's just something to look at. Like when you take into account seeing a graph like that, plus losing followers, plus low engagement, that's when you come to the conclusion that, hey, you know what? This page is definitely not worth my time. So yeah, guys, that is basically the process that me and Leo used to go ahead and rebuild up a network, to reach out for shoutouts. That is basically what we did. And once you find one good page, you go through that cycle of finding all the good pages within that niche, and then you tap them out. That is basically everything exactly. that I and have another, to say. If you have anything to add,
another quick trick that I'd like to give out is to make sure that when you find a good page, make sure that you're looking at the pages that they are following and also the pages that are on the suggested list underneath that page, because those are often a good indicator that they could be good pages as well.
Definitely. Yep. Anybody that they're following, because a lot of times pages take content from other pages, and they're all kind of like in, they'd probably be in DM groups together as well, and they're all helping each other grow.
Definitely.
But yeah, guys, so that is the exact process you want to use, whether you're, again, whether you're trying to find an influencer for shout outs, for giveaways, for promoting a product, anything. That is the best way to decide whether or not an influencer is good or not. I think that is the most fail-proof way. If you run everything the way we did, the amount of times you run into a bad influencer is going to be very, very low when you do extensive homework like this. So with that all said, that's all I have to say. Leo, if that's all you have to say, then I think this video is complete.
Yep, that's it for now.
All right, guys. So we'll see you guys on the next one.